Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Cammie Dunaway.
Good morning, and welcome to everyone. Those of you here in Club Nokia, and in the Nokia Theater, and all of you watching online. There is one thing that every one of us attending here in person has in common: a professional connection to video games. Whether we make them, sell them, report on them, or analyze the companies that do all of that, we know that how well we do individually is directly linked to how well our category is doing. So, how are we trending? Well, NPD says that last year, video games were just as big as home video, just as big as toys, and even bigger than music and movie box office put together. The reason is obvious. Once our industry defined our consumers in a limited way, focusing only on those people who were already actively involved as gamers. Now, it's different. Maybe you've noticed a woman on the plane playing the Nintendo DS system, or your uncle calling you for tips on how to beat his buddies in Mario Kart. Today, it's clear: everyone's game. Now, certainly different companies are trying to build audience in different ways. At Nintendo, we've been working nonstop at what sounds like a pretty simple goal: create surprise. Now, once in a while, surprise breaks down the door in the form of absolute innovation, something so amazing that everyone instantly recognizes it. And sometimes, it sort of creeps up on you. A grin or a shout buried in the middle of a level. Today, we will bring you both: innovation in the form of the next leap forward in game control, and surprises in places where you thought there might not be any left. So let's kick off with that last point. If there's an icon for video games, it's probably the guy who's appeared in over 200 different titles and sold more than 200 million games globally. He's someone who seems like he's already done it all. Now, Mario in 3D was great. I think everyone remembers the first time leaping into one of the pictures in the castle. But we admit we haven't quite figured out how to move him into a fourth dimension. But that number, 4, that's the key to Mario's next surprise. For the last 15 years, Mr. Miyamoto has been thinking about one new way to let you play a Mario game that's never been possible before. Today, here's his answer: new Super Mario Brothers for Wii. To explain and demonstrate, please welcome Bill Trinan from our Treehouse group. Bill?
Thank you, Cammie. Now, as Cammie pointed out, creating something new for a game as classic as Super Mario Brothers is hard to do. We managed to do it on Nintendo DS, and 18 million people around the globe appreciated the surprise that that game had to offer. But when our development team in Kyoto asked what they could do to make an all-new New Super Mario Brothers game for Wii, the answer wasn't just more levels, more enemies, and more items. It was also more players. So Cammie, why don't you come back out and play along with some of our friends from the Treehouse? I think it's only fair that you get to play as Mario. So Nate Bildorf will be joining as Luigi, J.C. Rodrigo as Blue Toad, and Rich Amtower as Yellow Toad. Now, play control is as simple as it ever was, with a few new twists added in. You can play with 1 to 4 players, and item boxes generally produce 1 item for each player in the game, but not always. And it doesn't always mean that 1 player is going to get an item. Now, I think we've already seen 1 player lose a life, and that's 2. You're seeing a couple of new features here. The first, you can pick up and carry other players. Now, if you're cooperatively minded, you can do that to help save them from those enemies or those pits. If you have other things in mind, you might want to throw them at those enemies or those pits. Now, the other thing that you've noticed is when people do lose a life, they have a tendency to come back inside of a bubble. Now, again, if you're nice, you might want to let them out of the bubble so they can come back in and continue to play. But if you want to get all the coins for yourself, you don't necessarily have to. You'll notice that the game does include many of the classic trappings, warp pipes, hidden areas, lots of coins to collect. You'll also notice that this time around, the battle for those coins is probably a little bit more fierce. Now, I'm just going to let them play for a little bit while I tell you a little bit about the structure of how this game works and the balance between single player and multiplayer. The main mode of the game you can play in single player mode. Or, if you want to, you can play it in co-op with up to 4 players. You can start in one, and you can switch to the other at any point in time. So if you happen to find a particularly hard level, you can call your friends over for help. What you see here is another new item. This is the propeller suit. If I had one of those, I'd be wearing it every day. That thing is sweet. Quick little shake of the Wii remote will shoot you high up in the sky, and you'll slowly drift back down. Now, of course, you can do that to save yourself from one of those pits, or you can use it to help yourself find new levels. Uh-oh. Looks like Blue Toad had a little trouble there. I wonder if anybody's going to... Oh, let him out. Very nice. Now, you can see that with 4 players, there's a lot going on. The screen is nice enough that it'll pan out to a much wider view when people spread out. But if the player at the lead goes a little bit too fast, you may find that if you're at the back, you get wiped off screen.
Stop that.
You'll also find some nice use of hidden areas, pipes and things like that as well. And I think at this point, we're probably getting closer to the end of the game, or at least the end of this level at any rate. Yes, sliding, more propeller suits. And here we get to the end of the level. Oh, Luigi. Now, as soon as 1 player touches the flagpole, the others have about 3 seconds for them to grab on if they want to get any bonus points. And at the end of every level, you get a nice tally. Shows you how many coins you collected, how many enemies you stomped, tallies up all your bonus points, and gives you a ranking. So let's see how things panned out here. Well, looks like first place goes to Rich. Second place to Luigi, always the underdog. Third goes to JC as Blue Toad. And Cammy, looks like you came in fourth.
Respectable.
Well, guys, thanks for playing.
Thanks, guys.
Cammy, we'll give it back to you.
All right. Thanks, guys. Okay, this is why I make my living selling games rather than developing them. But we're happy to announce that new Super Mario Brothers for Wii can be played this week on the show floor and will launch worldwide holiday 2009. Now, we know that players will be lining up to play with and against each other in Mr. Miyamoto's newest masterpiece. Now, while Mario may be a big draw, even he wasn't big enough to attract all consumers to our category. In fact, there are millions of people who never stepped up to gaming until they stepped on to this. In the 13 months since it launched, Wii Fit has been the best-selling video game in America and around the world. Some analysts have stopped looking at the Wii balance board as a simple accessory and started considering it as a separate gaming platform. That's because with 15 million sold, it now ranks alongside other home systems in terms of worldwide installed base. In fact, tens of millions around the world are enjoying Wii Fit. But as we all know, sticking with any exercise doesn't always happen. So we began looking at ways to make We Fit easier to apply to your daily life, more beneficial, and even more attractive for every member of the household. We'd like to introduce you to the result, We Fit Plus. Now, the original game was designed to have something for everyone. This next version moves in an added direction, helping find a specific workout routine that's exactly right for you. Now, from the main menu, you can now enter the locker room, where you'll become, in effect, your own personal trainer. There are 6 new strength and yoga activities included in We Fit Plus, but the key is how you mix and match individual elements. You can combine them in any order that you want, and you can even repeat the ones that you find particularly helpful. You can omit all the current interludes between exercises so that your routine can move continuously 20, 30, even 40 minutes at a time. This customization can also work on particular needs. If you want to target a specific body area for strengthening or for toning or for conditioning, there are programs to help reach all of those goals. Now, We Fit Plus will even keep track of the total calories that you burn. Now, at the same time, this can't be entirely about fitness. What makes it Nintendo is that it's also a lot of fun. There are 15 new balance games. Now, behind me, you can see some of them. Juggling, skateboarding, and one called Perfect 10, where you need to swing your hips in different directions to choose number combinations that total 10. Maybe you can think of this as brain age for your backside. Now let me highlight just one more, where you will be leaping from platform to platform, swinging, dodging cannonballs, and jumping over rolling timber. Now yes, these moves are reminiscent of someone you've known forever. But this is the first time you'll be able to understand what it's really like to run a mile in Mario's shoes. And We Fit Plus, with the new personalization options, will arrive this fall as a bundle with the Wii Balance Board. And the software will also be available as a standalone purchase for those who already have the Wii Balance Board. This evolution of the We Fit phenomenon should keep We itself right where it's always been, top of mind.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Reggie Fils-Aimé.
Wii continues to attack the games market like no system before. The march is advancing on multiple fronts. Innovative software, both from Nintendo and third parties. An easy-to-use philosophy that has pushed adoption beyond mainstream gaming and right into the middle of mainstream culture. And the battle plan has been communicated virally, boosted by word-of-mouth recommendation and hands-on testing. But the primary weapon for all of this is interface. First, there was a thing that looked like an odd TV remote. Then all of a sudden, you realized it was controlling the action in an entirely new way. Then the nunchuck, which kept the joystick in play. And most recently, a new platform that has moved the gaming ground under our feet and opened up another separate path for game control for millions of new players. Today, we want to fully explain the next advance in game control, one that takes us from this to this. Now, well, obviously, I can't use the old marketing line, you can see the difference, because just looking, you almost don't notice that little extender. Most people won't see the difference until they hit the power button. Then what emerges is a new sense of realism in gameplay. Not the kind that makes a game look more real, but one that makes it feel and play more real. For a couple decades, players only used their fingers to control game action. Today, they're off the couch. In fact, over the last few years, physical reality has become the new proving ground for game innovation. Now, Wii Motion Plus introduces an unprecedented level of physical reality by adding precision control. Take a look. Well, that's how it works on video. But on video, you can do almost anything. So to give you a real-time feel for this next dimension in physical reality, please welcome back Bill Trinan.
At last year's E3, we gave you only a taste of Wii Sports Resort. From the video, you got an idea of the breadth of activities. Now, I'd like to show you more of the precision and depth Wii Motion Plus adds to Wii Sports Resort. Now, Wii Motion Plus detects the position of your Wii remote, detects the angle you hold it at. It knows all that there is to know about how and where you are holding your controller and applies it to the game. Combined, the Wii Remote and Wii Motion Plus offer precision in motion. So let's see how that precision can be applied to gameplay. I'll start by showing you how you and everyone else who plays the game will also start by jumping out of an airplane.
Okay, here we go.
With Wii Motion Plus, my Wii Remote is my me in skydiving, the first activity that you'll encounter in the game. Now you can see, I can spin him around, I can turn and twist, I can position my Mii to grab other Mii skydivers. And if I want to, hello everybody. I can dive straight down to speed up my descent, or I can flatten out to grab a few more of my friends. Let's see how many I can get here. Oh, there's another one. And one more. Woo! So as you can see, it's a lot of fun. Now this is just the beginning of the game, so we'll have a little fun falling in formation. Go upside down, probably not too safe. We want to make a safe landing. Try to get us right in position. The chute's open. Welcome to Wii Sports Resort. From this fun and simple introduction, every single player will immediately understand how to use Wii Motion Plus and how it is different from the standard Wii Remote. And that's before you even set foot on the island. Next up, I'd like to take you through archery. It's a sport that controls just like it would in real life, but just like real life, one that requires a great deal of skill. To play, you hold the Wii Remote vertically in your left hand if you're right-handed, or vice versa if you're left-handed, just like you would hold a real bow. Press the A button with your thumb to grip the bow. It feels great. Hold down the Z button on the nunchuck, draw back your bowstring. And you can see how every pan left to right, up and down, is accurately reflected on screen. Oh, come on, I can do better than that. You'll also notice there's a wind gauge in the top right-hand corner. So I'm having to compensate here for distance, for wind, and other factors like a moving target. Oh, that's not better than the first shot. All right, we'll try this once more. Actually, we're going to try a second target after this. You also notice that as I draw back the bowstring, my vision zooms in. And the longer that I hold the bowstring back, the smaller my area of focus becomes. So there is some timing element to it as well. So we're going to go through three more shots here. You get three shots per target. You'll notice that to compensate for distance, I'm going to have to arch my shot just a little bit, just like I would a real bow.
Seven.
And as you can see, it's not about learning the controls. It's about doing what comes naturally.
Four.
And from that point on, it's all dependent on your own skills, which is precisely the kind of challenge that longtime gamers strive for. Oh. Not a good shot. Well, I've got one more sport to show you today, but of course it wouldn't be very sporting without a little competition. So, since I'm a glutton for punishment, I figure why not invite Reggie back out on stage for a little three-point contest. Reggie?
I hope you shoot baskets better than you shoot arrows.
Oh, man. I didn't know that was coming. You ready to see who shoots better from downtown, Reggie?
You know, normally my game is that inside power game, but we'll see.
Yeah, if I was playing against you in the paint, I might be scared. Now, the beautiful thing about basketball is that, once again, the controls are simple. You simply hold the Wii Remote, you aim, and you shoot the ball at the hoop. You know where that is, right?
Yes, I do.
And then all you need, some good aim, a little flick of the wrist, both for style and for accuracy. But of course, I hear that you know all of this because you're hitting the court like 3-4 times a week.
No, I tell Mr. Iwata every waking moment I'm working.
I think he's going to find out the truth today. Well, you know, my problem is I haven't played basketball since I was in middle school, so I'm going to have to channel a much younger version of myself to beat you. You think you can handle a 4'9" 8th grader?
4'9"? Is that how tall you were then or how tall you are now?
Brutal. Oh, very funny. You ready to go, big man?
I'm ready to go.
All right, count of three. One, two, three. Now you got to reach down, grab the ball, and then shoot. Some people find that the full motion from the tip of your toes to the flick of the wrist really helps.
Oh, I missed the last shot.
I'm at 4. How are you?
Now I'm at 4.
Uh-oh.
Ooh.
Oh. Oh, man. This is a bad rack for me. There we go.
I was throwing up some bricks.
Now, the nice thing is that once you find your rhythm, you can kind of keep it going, just like a real three-point contest. Oh, I'm at 10. Oh,
nine.
I missed the money ball. That was 2 points. Dang it. Mm. Oh, now I'm feeling it. How's that, Reggie?
14.
Oh. 16 right here. Oh. Oh. Oh, no. Oh. The money ball saves you.
On the money ball.
Wow. Nice shooting, Tex. I better get off stage before I get embarrassed anymore.
Thanks, Bill. Wii Sports Resort brings a new level of physical reality to a world that is distinctly Nintendo and launches here in the Americas on July 26th. But others are putting Wii Motion Plus to work even sooner. For example, Electronic Arts has announced Tiger Woods PGA Tour 10 will not only employ Wii Motion Plus technology, but the game and the accessory will be sold together. EA's Grand Slam Tennis for Wii will also incorporate Wii Motion Plus technology. And for the first time, Sega's Virtua Tennis will be served up for a Nintendo home platform also featuring Wii Motion Plus precision. What this means is that every little mistake you make in the real world when you currently bury your backhand into the net or slice your three wood out of bounds will be faithfully reflected in the game. This new dimension in physical reality will have you muttering all the same bad words you do in real life. All three games will be available in a matter of weeks. And for Ubisoft's Red Steel franchise, the commitment to Wii Motion Plus is absolute. Red Steel 2 will be playable only with Wii Motion Plus control. These new titles begin to suggest how third-party development is flowing to Nintendo. And that's because last year in America, more third-party games were sold for Wii than any other platform. And Nintendo DS came in second. That trend, one that incorporates every game genre, will only grow this year. For example, let's focus for a minute on just one game category, the RPG. If Wii Motion Plus is all about physical reality, RPGs are mainly about what goes on inside your head. The story, the strategy, the quests, and the combat. RPGs allow developers to vary their approach. For Square Enix, this means an exclusive open-world adventure built specifically for Wii, introducing a highly interactive environment for the Final Fantasy franchise.
I do not have time to play with you.
Oh, don't say that, Goldenrod. I still have some energy to burn.
This is a crystal idol. This guy's a bearer!
So what if I am?
Leave it to me.
Crystal bearers are abominations. That's what everyone believes.
What happened just now?
Can he be trusted?
Wahoo! The Crystal Bearers.
And Square is also bringing a classic RPG franchise to Nintendo DS. An exclusive version of Kingdom Hearts will be available on September 29th, and the look and feel are incredible.
I want to be With you two.
You must have known that this was going to happen.
So, do you hate me for taking your friend away from you?
We have to set things right.
No, wait!
Yeah. Look at me, Roxas. Who do you see?
For several months, roleplay fans in Japan have discovered that Bowser, that longtime bad guy, really does suck. And I mean that in a good way. The latest Mario and Luigi RPG game, subtitled Bowser's Inside Story, has the world's most famous game brothers reduced to microbe size and ingested by their arch enemy, where they go to work checking out Bowser's internal pipes. And here again, I mean that in a good way. Fans in the West have waited long enough to take their turn at this action, but they don't have to wait much longer. Mario and Luigi, Bowser's Inside Story, will be available at retail both in North America and Europe this fall. And before we leave the RPG category, there's one more piece of important news. A legendary RPG name is on its way back to Nintendo Portables. A franchise that's been gone for quite a while. After going dark 6 years ago, 2010 will bring a new dawn with Golden Sun DS.
The Nintendo DS line remains the world's most lucrative target for game creation, coupling low development costs with a global installed base now exceeding 100 million units. That kind of installed base lets developers take risks and innovate. I want to show you three examples. If there's a current king of mystery writing, it's probably James Patterson, who's authored dozens of different bestsellers. Beginning on October the 13th, you'll be enjoying Patterson's work in a new way. His Women's Murder Club, Games of Passion from THQ, reads and plays like an interactive novel and will help usher both casual gamers and passionate readers into the wider universe of video games.
Why join a book club when you can join the Women's Murder Club? This October, James Patterson, author of 40 New York Times bestsellers, brings an all-new mystery to your Nintendo DS and DSi. Women's Murder Club, Games of Passion. Play the part of Detective Lindsay Boxer, reporter Cindy Thomas, or Dr. Claire Washburn. Uncover hidden clues. Analyze scientific evidence. Interrogate suspects to reveal secret motives. This is James Patterson's suspense at its very best. And it's up to you to catch the killer. Women's Murder Club, Games of Passion.
Now, while Women's Murder Club might appeal first to relatively new gamers, there's also new intellectual property from Ubisoft that goes the other direction. A new Nintendo DS adventure, Cop the Recruit, will have an immediate attraction for fans of grittier, more urban, open-world gaming. We'd like to introduce you to a young New York cop forced undercover to unravel the conspiracy that's framed his partner.
My name is Dan. Dan Myers. Underground street racer. Unstoppable. Or so I thought. The day I was arrested, I got two choices. A life behind bars or a life behind the wheel. My first undercover mission? Take down a terrorist leader bent on wiping out New York City. No kidding. The badge is fast, but the street is faster.
Now let's shift gears again. For several months, fashionistas in Japan have been designing their own outfits and decorating their own boutiques with Nintendo DS game Girls Mode. In America, it will be known as Style Savvy, and we expect it will further expand female gameplay for preteens and 20-somethings. As you can see, Nintendo DS equals diversity. It's the platform that literally delivers on the old promise, something for everyone. Now, and while Nintendo DS allows developers to experiment with almost anything they want, the new Nintendo DSi lets them think about delivering surprise in ways that just weren't possible before. And Nintendo DSi is already capturing the passion of players. Take a look.
Got the original DS, I got to the DS Lite, and now I'm gonna get a DSi.
Well, I really like the direction that they're going right now, which is what can you and I do together?
I'm a very on-the-go person, so it's a very on-the-go system for me.
I love being able to carry it around wherever I want, pop it open, pop it closed.
It's really awesome how many games there are, touch screen, and you're like in the game.
You know, you've got games involving the camera, also got, you know, the microphone there, you've got the touchpad.
The internet's gonna be awesome. and the music player is even cooler.
Me and my sister are always playing against each other. I like the idea that I can play it with my friends and have it be a group activity as opposed to just me being alone playing by myself.
I just couldn't put it down.
Awesome.
I'm really excited to see what's coming up in the future.
When we first talked about Nintendo DSi coming to America, we predicted that it would naturally complement the current Nintendo DS Lite. After all, different features, different price points, and at least initially, different audiences. So far, that's exactly what's happening. As of today, total Nintendo DSi sales in America in the 2 months since launch have surpassed 1 million units. And during that same time period, consumers have purchased another 400,000 Nintendo DS Lites. Now, the key difference between Nintendo DS Lite and Nintendo DSi is personalization. It's the way every owner can make it his or her own. Now, depending on what you download, the content you capture, and how you manipulate that content, your portable is going to feel like no one else's. Obviously, that reflects a wider trend that's going on all around us. People today don't just consume entertainment, they create it and then share it, sometimes with their friends and sometimes with the general public. Now, earlier this spring, we demonstrated Moving Memo, software for Nintendo DSi that lets you create your own little animations and then broadcast them to the world. Today, we can announce that this simple movie maker called Flipnote Studio here in America will be available to Nintendo DSi owners this summer. Now, other user-generated content is also on the way. Mario versus Donkey Kong is the franchise's third offering, but the first to let players design levels from the ground up. Not only will players have full control over where to set traps, enemies, and a host of power-ups in the construction zone, but they can also upload their creation to friends locally or via Nintendo Wi-Fi connection. Now, when the minis aren't marching through your own diabolical creations, they're navigating puzzles that harken back to the arcade debut of Mario and Donkey Kong. Now, as always, obstacles lie between the minis and their goal. But what are these obstacles? Well, now, that's mostly up to you. Mario versus Donkey Kong, Minis March Again, is playable on the show floor and is available only as a download for Nintendo DSi via DSiWare beginning June 8th. That's right, this coming Monday. Now, here's another title that puts the concept of user-generated content on center stage. WarioWare DIY, as in do-it-yourself, includes a feature for players to design their own games from scratch. Every element, the characters, the environment, the actions, even the purpose of the microgame itself is controlled entirely by the player. We believe this is as close to essential game design as any title has ever come. Now, the fundamentals here are simple, but the decision-making process, inventing the very nature of the challenge, makes this experience deeply compelling. And when your microgame is completed, you can share it with other WarioWare DIY owners. Now, after all, creating content is only half the fun. For example, no matter how goofy you make your best friend look with the new Nintendo DSi camera, the real satisfaction comes when you can show that image to everyone. And that's about to get a lot easier. Beginning this summer, you'll be able to automatically upload photos taken with your Nintendo DSi and share them with your friends on Facebook. Now, while millions of photos are uploaded to Facebook every day, the new Nintendo DSi with its 10 editing lenses, makes it even more fun to personalize and share your photos with some of the 200 million users on Facebook. Now, while user-generated content is hot, we don't intend to get entirely carried away with it. After all, the great majority of Nintendo DS owners will spend the majority of their time enjoying what professional developers create for them. And perhaps no Nintendo DS creation is more eagerly anticipated than the new game Mr. Iwata disclosed earlier this spring, The Legend of Zelda: Spirit Tracks. But words can't do it justice. After all, playing is believing. I've played it, and so can you, on the show floor this week. Between new Nintendo DS games and new Nintendo DSi opportunity, there has never been so much going on for Nintendo portables. Stop by the Nintendo booth to test drive not only new games, but also new experiences. In our world, everyone's game. Now, please join me in welcoming the man who is leading Nintendo's efforts, explaining that there is a gamer inside everyone, our global president, Mr. Satoru Iwata.
Thank you, Cammy, and good morning. When Nintendo first began talking about bringing millions of more people to video games, many thought that was impossible. But today, these things have come to be accepted. And as a result, the global gaming population is greatly expanded. But there are some now who believe the audience expansion movement is beginning to fade. Recently, we have been continuously conducting our own research around the world to find out what's happening. Nintendo divides the population into three basic groups: those who actively play games, those who say they will never play, and those who might someday. Obviously, if the population of gamers is to grow further, it must come from this group of maybes. So, how many are there? In Japan, the United States, and six countries we measured in Europe, there are already more than 295 million people actively playing console or handheld video games. These people, of course, are big software purchasers. But at the same time, there are more than 149 million people in these territories who say they might be interested in getting involved. To put this another way, for every two people now playing, there's one more just waiting to jump into the game. Imagine the opportunity if the number of players was 50% larger than it is right now. As the data show, we still have a long way to go in expanding the gaming population. As a matter of fact, it is the ability to appeal to such new players that may decide the fate of entire platform. We have been able to erase the viewpoint that those who never played games in the past will also never play them in the future. And our next goal is to create individual titles which can actually satisfy every kind of game player, even though the range of experience and skill level within the gaming population is now much wider. This is a rather unprecedented challenge. Previously, the best games were always considered those that require the most advanced skills. However, this kind of assumption concerns me. In the world of entertainment, making it harder for newcomers to join is a dangerous strategy. Always raising the bar on the necessary skills for players means that the number of people who feel like getting started with games must necessarily decrease. But on the other hand, if we simply lower the bar, we won't satisfy highly skilled players. And I am also troubled by the imaginary wall that is built higher and higher between what is considered an experienced player and a novice, between the veterans and the newcomers. After all, every one of us was a new player at one time. No one was born an expert gamer. Maybe we began on Space Invader or Pong or Donkey Kong. These were all immensely popular, but at the same time, intuitive enough to be enjoyed by everyone. Ideally, this is still possible to create products that can satisfy both advanced players and novice players simultaneously. Last year, Nintendo began to address this by introducing the combination of Mario Kart Wii software and Wii Wheel. We feel we've made a certain amount of progress. Maybe you yourself have played this game with a casual or even non-gamer. And we intend to move further toward that goal with some key products you've seen today, New Super Mario Bros. Wii, Wii Sports Resort, and Wii Fit Plus. Whether you never played games before or already consider yourself an expert at such titles, we believe these games will please you with a depth that might surprise you. In a sense, each of these could be considered everyone's game. We believe the right product can increase mutual understanding and therefore increase the social standing of all game players. But finally, I understand that this kind of solution alone might not be entirely convincing. Most of the names we talked about today are familiar even to current non-players. What has most attracted new players so far are entirely different approaches, software like Brain Age and Wii Fit. What's next? I thought I should give you at least one potential answer. So today, as a sneak peek, I'd like to show you another entirely different way of thinking about games. With Brain Age, Nintendo proposed training your brain. With Wii Fit, we suggested using balance to train your body. Today, please look for the first time at the Wii Vitality Sensor. When you insert your finger, the Wii Vitality Sensor first recognizes your pulse. But pulse is not just a measurement of your heartbeat. Our pulse contains a number of other signals being transmitted by our bodies. The point here is, once again, to visualize something which otherwise is invisible. For example, how nervous am I up here on stage today? How focused am I on remembering my script? These things are normally invisible. Just as we enable you to see the center of your body balance with Wii Fit, the Wii Vitality Sensor intends to have you see the information relating to the inner world of your body. People would be able to use the product we are developing with this Wii Vitality Sensor to achieve greater relaxation. Maybe everyone under pressure in our stressful society could use this as a way to relax with a video game. Traditionally, video games have been developed to give an increased sense of excitement or stimulation. But it may not be long before games are also used to let people unwind or even make it easier to fall asleep. We believe when the previous strict definitions of video game are removed, when more and more software are developed, which can be played regardless of skill or difficulty level, then the wonderful potential of our kind of entertainment can blossom in full. And I very much look forward to that day. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. Iwata, for that look into the future. Now, relaxation aside, the fact is we've still got a little stimulation to deliver. We began our presentation with Mario, appearing for the first time in four-player mode. We've also shown him alongside Luigi in their latest RPG. And we've seen him facing off against Donkey Kong, this time in an adventure that players themselves can help invent. But if you think that that's all the Mario news you can handle, you might want to think again. Because for the first time ever, a second full 3D Mario title is going to appear on a single Nintendo console.
What we've shown you today are the latest steps in our constant goal of bringing more kinds of game experiences to more kinds of gamers. Some of it with innovation, some of it in the form of surprise. Wii Sports Resort, New Super Mario Bros. Wii, Wii Fit Plus, Golden Sun DS, Mr. Iwata's Wii Vitality Sensor announcement, and the game creation elements on Nintendo DS. They all serve this purpose very well. But I'll be honest, I read the blogs too. And I've been a gamer myself for a long time. I know there are still people out there listening who are saying, okay, great, but I want more. And that more is generally associated with publishers not named Nintendo. So let me offer just three examples of third-party titles with a little harder edge, ones you'll be playing exclusively on Wii before year end. The first is new IP from Sega that you've heard about before and will be picking up at retail in just 3 weeks. The Conduit was built from the ground up specifically for Wii and introduces us to the all-seeing eye.
It's time to go to work.
How can mankind fight a war the enemy has already won?
There's no time, Michael. This city is doomed. You've got to hurry.
Capcom's Resident Evil has long been a popular choice on Nintendo platforms, and it's a top seller for Wii. It's a franchise that works both as a shooter and as an adventure. And with Resident Evil: The Dark Side Chronicles, you're going to see familiar characters in a new light. Last year, Electronic Arts put its full weight behind a new intellectual property, Dead Space. The action was frantic, but left fans with an important question. Exactly how did that disaster happen? There's only one place they'll find the answer, and it's on a new version of the series built exclusively for Wii called Dead Space Extraction.
I can feel them. All around.
I know. But there's us four. We've done okay so far.
Oh, God!
Quiet.
Listen.
Oh, Jesus. We're never getting out of here.
Look out!
Hurry!
Have you seen those things? That could have been us.
You can't stop it! No one can stop it!
It's coming. From one of us.
Panic are commencing in 5, 4, 3, 2...
Oh God, I don't want to die here.
Third-party publishers are drawn to opportunity. And right now, there's no opportunity larger than Nintendo. And you're going to have the opportunity to play each of these excellent games at the show here this week. But what about Nintendo itself? Could a new, edgier game also be coming from us? The answer is absolutely. And since two heads are better than one, we invited one of the most celebrated development teams in the world, one with a proven track record in the mature space to join us in taking a fresh look at a storied franchise. Here's a preview of what we've been creating together.
Lady.
Cammy started out today talking about surprise. And I'm guessing even the most passionate Metroid fans found some surprise in that trailer for Metroid Other M. What I can tell you is that this historic collaboration is going to reveal a Metroid game unlike any you've experienced before. It will take you deeper into Samus's story and further into the Metroid universe. Again, this is in keeping with one of the timeless missions of Nintendo, bringing you names that are so familiar, but revitalized to make them new again. At the same time, Wii Motion Plus and the Wii Vitality Sensor are new devices that can transport you to new worlds of gaming. In the end, we believe we can provide something for everyone. We believe there's a place in gaming for everyone. And we remain committed to making Nintendo everyone's game. Thank you for your attention this morning, and we look forward to seeing you on the show floor.